Hello everyone, this is Odit. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, we are again going to discuss one low-level system design problem, and the problem's name is multi-level cache system. So it is not a normal cache system, it is a multi-level cache system, and if you are looking actually for a video of a normal cache system, then there is a separate video which I have created previously. I have put the link of that video into the description. So if you want, you can watch that video. But this is specifically for multi-level cache system and not a single cache system, okay? So let's start. So first of all, let's see what problem statement are we solving, right? So let me just open the problem statement. Right, so as I said, we are going to design a multiple level cache management system. And when we say there are multiple levels cache management system, then we mean the cache that we are going to use, the system that we are going to build is a multi-layered cache system. It's a system which is going to be used by somebody else to take advantage of caches. And this is the requirements that are given to us are that the system that we are going to build should have multi-level caches. So it should be like, you know, first of all, L1 cache, then L2 cache, then L3 cache, and so on up to LN. So N will be given to us, and we have to, you know, design a system so that we can support this multi-layer cache system. So this type of system is actually helpful when you have, you know, different types of caches available to you with different latencies and different performance availabilities, right? So for example, even in your CPU that you have, there are multiple caches, right? L1 and L2, and then RAM and those kind of memories that you have. So different kinds of caches actually allow you to, you know, put, first of all, use first cache, which is the way faster cache. Then if the data is not there, then, you know, rely on the second cache. If the data is not in second cache, then go to the third cache, and so on. So in whichever cache you find the data first, you use the data from there. So that's the usage of multi-level cache system. But actually, we are not going to see how multi-level cache system benefits you. The idea is, the requirements are given to us that it has to be a multi-level cache system, and we have to just build it. We cannot build a single cache system because that's the requirement given to us. Okay. Cool. So as I said, L1, L2, and L3, and so on up to LN will be the caches, actually the layers, and each layer will store the key value pairs of data, right? And both the key and value are of type string. So we do not have multiple types of keys or values in the problem statement. L1 is the top layer with the most priority. So first of all, the call comes to L1, and you know, the LN is the least priority, or is the last layer. So the call comes to LN at the last, if the data is not found in L1, L2, and so on up to L3, and to LN-1, right? Then you are given following requirements for the actually the details of the system. So you are given the number of levels of cache. So you are actually given like how many levels are there in the cache. Actually, you are also given the caches type for each of the layer, because you know, that's the whole idea of the system, that you can actually support different types of caches at each layer. And the capacity of each layer is also given. So the number of elements that can be stored in a single layer, they are also given. There is something called read time of each layer. So read time is actually the time you take to read the item from the cache. Then the write time of each layer is also given. Then write time, as it's signifies, it's a write time, the time it takes to write to the cache at that particular layer, right? So this is not for the whole cache. These values are given for each layer of the cache, right? Now, there are some operations given to us which this cache system should provide. So first of all, the operations that are required are very straightforward. Like, these are read and write operations, and you can actually, these are actually the required operations from the cache, right? So the read operation, it says like it will start reading from L1. If the key is found at this layer, then the value will be returned. If the key is not found at this layer, then it will try to read from the next layer it will start from L1, then L2, then L3, and until it finds the key, it will keep moving on to the next layer. And if it finds the key, then it will just return it from that layer. Now, it says that when it returns from that layer, it will put that key value in all the previous layers also. So for example, let's say L1, L2, and L3, and L4, the four layers are there, and we find the key at L3. So we will not visit L4, but because we found the key at L3, but since we have found the key at L3, and L1 and L2 were missing the keys, so when returning the value from L3, we will also populate the key in L1 and L2 caches. This is helpful because next time when you read the key again, then you will find directly from the L1, and that's the whole idea of cache, right? the most frequent values are found easily, right? So that's the read operation given to you. Now, total read time that we have to specify, you know, so for each operation, for both the read, the full read operation, I mean, not for a specific layer, but the full read operation that your cache provides. Similarly, the full write operation that your multi-layer cache provides, they have to return the total read time it took and total write time it took. Okay. And it has to provide a sum of both. So for example, here in the read key operation, the total time that you have to return is the sum of read times of all the labels where you read and write times of all the labels where you write, right? So let's say if in the same example, L1, L2, L3 and L4, you find at L3 and so here you read the value at L1, L2 and L3, right? And then you wrote at L1 and L2 one day, correct? So the total read time, total time for this read key operation would be read time of L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus write time of L1 plus write time of L2, right? So that's the total time that you have to return. And that's the one thing, like you have to return the total, the value of the key and the total time taken to read it, right? So similarly, the write key operation is given to us. In the write key operation, we will start from level L1 and, you know, we will write the key at this level and all the levels below it, right? And if at any level, the value of the key is same as the given value, then we don't write it and we just skip that level and we just go to the next level and we just return it from this particular level, right? So here, we will start from level 1, we write it. If it's not there, we then go to level 2, we again write it. If it's not there, and so on, we will go up to LN. So at each level, we just, you know, see if the key and value are already present or not. If they are present, we don't write it. If they are not present, then we write it. Just like read operation, we return the total read time. Similarly, here we have to return the total write key operation. I mean, time taken to write key operation, right? And the total time for write on the full cache is the write times of all the labels where you write and read time of all the labels where you read, right? It's actually the same. And you have to print the total time that it took to write this value. Great. There was a bonus requirement or bonus point that was given to us, which was an stat operation. So it was not a required operation. I mean, we were not expected to, we are not actually expected to perform it or implement it. But if we do it, then we get the bonus point. So let's just go through it by what bonus requirement is. So bonus requirement operation says like it should print three information whenever this operation is performed. The three information is current usage of each level of cache, like how much percentage of cache at each level is filled. Second thing it should print it is the average read time of the whole cache system for the last 10 read operations. So the average read time for the last 10 read operations we have to print. Similarly, average write time of this multi-level cache system for the last 10 write operations. As I said, this bonus part was optional and candidates were not required to implement it, but if they implement it, they will obviously be rated higher than others, right? And then, I mean, that was actually problem statement. What problem are we solving? Then, I mean, like the normal expectations that we have from an LLD round are definitely there, that the code should be clean, it should be more readable, it should be more extensible, it should follow some OOPS patterns, you know, so those things are anyways expected. So that were not explicitly written over here, but they were actually given to us. So actually this problem statement was given in an interview to me actually, and this solution that I have, I actually presented this solution in that interview only, and I thought of creating the video over here. So this problem is actually from the direct interview. So this is the problem, and let's now see what solution did I create. Okay,